Okay, dear students, in the last class we were going to discuss about the comparison of conductor material in various overhead systems. And for that we have taken some assumptions like P is the power in watts which we want to transmit, Vm is the maximum voltage of the line between the conductor and the ground, and L is the length at which we want to transmit the power, and W is the line losses in watts which we have discussed in the previous class. Okay, one by one I am going to tell the various kind of systems, and accordingly we will compare how much conductor material is required for each system. Okay, so first I am taking for DC power, for DC system, P equals to VI. Therefore, line current can be mentioned as Vm into I1, where Vm is the maximum voltage between the conductor and ground, and I1 is the current flowing through the transmission system. Okay. Here now line current is given by I1 equals to P upon Vm. Okay. Now R is the resistance of conductor, that is given by rho L upon A1, and line losses, that is given by W1. Since there are two conductors, each conductor will have line losses I square R. So two conductors will have the line losses equals to 2 into I square R. Okay, so it can be written as 2 I1 square R1, and that can be written as 2 into PVM or W1 equals to equals to, since two conductors are there, then For volume, we can multiply the area of cross section with the length of conductor wire, then we can get the volume. So since two conductors are there, so it will be given as 2A1 into L1. So it can combine dimension as 2 into 2 P square rho L upon Now, this is the volume of conductor material required for a DC two wire system with one conductor earth. And we can consider this system as reference one, so that the another conductor material required in different kind of system will be compared with this system. So it can be assumed as K. So what we did here, since for DC power is given by P equals to V into I, that is Vm into I1, and from that we determine the line current, that is I1 equals to P upon Vm, and since the resistance of line conductor is given by R1, that is equals to rho L upon A1. Now we talk about the line losses. Line losses are 2I1 square R1. Why 2? Because there are 2 wires. Okay, so we put the value of I1 from this equation and R1 from this one. So it is given by this one. So combine W1 equals to 2 P square rho L upon Vm square A1. From this expression, we determine the area of cross section for the conductor, that is A1 equals to 2 P square rho L upon Vm square W1. Now we are talking about the volume of conductor. That is, how we can determine the volume? We can determine the volume by multiplying the area of cross section with the length of conductor, that is given by A1 into L. Since there are two conductors, that's why we are taking 2A1 into L. And from that, we determine this expression. And since we are considering this expression as reference, so we are considering it as K for the other exponential systems. Now second is DC two wire Okay, this is a representation of a DC two wire system with midpoint earth. Here what we are taking, the midpoint of the generating side is earth. So and we are having the voltage between the conductor and earth, that is given by Vm. So this point is earth. So the voltage across this part will be Vm, and for voltage for this part will be Vm. So combined it will be equal to 2 Vm. Okay, now in this case P equals to 2 Vm upon I2. Since this is a second case, we are taking current is I2 flowing through the circuit, and resistance would be R2. So here I2 equals to P upon 2Vm, R2 equals to rho L upon K2, line losses are given as W2, that is equals to 2 I2 square R2, that is expressed as 2 P square 4 Vm square rho L upon K2. That is commonly W2 equals to P square rho L upon 2 Vm square A2. Therefore, from this we can determine A2 equals to P V square rho L upon 2 Vm square W2. Okay. Now, volume of conductor. Equals to, since two conductors are there, so 2A2 into L. This is a simple way of expressing for determining the volume of conductor. So I am not going to again repeat the same sentences. This is the line current, this is the line conductor resistance, this is the line losses, and from that we determine the area of cross section of conductor. Now we are going to determine volume of conductor for this kind of system, and that is 2A2L, that is equals to 2P square rho L upon 2Vm square W2 into L. Now 2 to cancel out, so what we are getting, that is equals to P square rho L square Vm square W2, that can be equivalent to K by 4. Okay, from when comparing it with that expression we are getting K by 4. So what we can say? We can say the conductor material required in the DC 2-wire system with midpoint earth is 1/4 time that one is required in the DC 2-wire system with one conductor earth. So it is required less volume of conductor for the system. Okay. Now this is a DC system having three wires. This is one wire, two wire, and third wire. Okay. So I3 and I3. Again, I3 equals to P upon 2Vm. W3 equals to 2P square 4 Vm square conductors. Okay, therefore now what we are requiring, one 1 and half. So combined is 2.5. So for volume it should be 2.5 A3 into L. Because area of cross section is half of the area of cross section for the conductor for this kind of wire. Neutral wire. Since that means area of cross section of neutral wire equal to half of the conductor area, area of cross section of a particular conductor. From this, now 2.5 into P square, rho I square, 2 Vm square, W3. Okay? That is equal to 2.5 upon 2 equals to k by 4. If we are multiplying it with 2 by 2, then it will become 5 upon 16 k. Okay. For the simplicity, we are converting it into 5 upon 16. Otherwise, that is self-sufficient. What we can say? 2.5 k divided by 8. That is sufficient, but for the simplicity we are converting, we are multiplying and divide it by 2, so we are getting 5 upon 16 k. Okay, this is the arrangement of single phase 2 wire AC system with one conductor earth. Here the Vm is the maximum voltage between conductors, and its RMS in the case of AC we have to take the RMS value. So the RMS voltage will be Vm upon root 2, because Vm is the maximum voltage between conductors. Therefore, RMS voltage equals to Vm upon root 2. Now, again I4 equals to P upon Vm upon root 2, that equals to root 2 P upon Vm. W4 equals to 2 I4 square R4. Now that equals to 4 P square rho l upon Vm square A4. Okay? A4 equals to 4p square rho l upon Vm of square. And volume equals to 2a4 into L, that is equals to 2 into 4b square rho L square upon Vm square W4, and that is equals to 2k. Okay? Then if you are going for this kind of system, then it will require, then it will require two times the conductor material required in the DC two wire system. Okay? Okay, so I have to make one correction here. Since here P equals to V upon root 2 I 4 cos phi, since it is AC system, so there are some changes, minor changes are there. So with that we have to take cos phi also. So there will be cos phi every time. Cos phi every time. So it would be equals to 2k upon cos square phi, which is square, and cos square phi is again. So please make one minor changes here. P equals to Vm upon root 2 into I4 cos phi. So from that we will determine I4 equals to P upon Vm, P upon Vm root 2 cos phi. And from that we will determine W4, that is the line losses, that is given by this expression. And now we can determine the area of cross section through this one. And the volume of conductor is given by 2A4 into L. And when we are solving it, it equals to 2 of 2k upon cos square phi. Okay? And in the fifth case, single phase 2 wire AC system with midpoint earth, that is represented as representation of single phase 2 wire AC system with midpoint earth. Here RMS value will be, RMS voltage will be 2Vm upon root 2, that is given by root 2Vm. So here I phi equals to Pm root 2Vm cos phi, W phi equals to 2 I phi square R5, that is equals to 2P square 2Vm square cos square phi into rho L upon A5. 2 to cancel out. Now from here A4 equals to P square rho L upon Vm square cos square phi. Okay? And volume equals to 2A5 into L, that is given by 2 into P square rho L square Vm square cos square phi. Now that is equals to 2 upon 2 cos square phi. Now here volume is given by, after comparing with this one, we will obtain the volume equals to k upon 2 cos square phi. Okay? Now next system is single phase three wire system. Now we are discussing single phase three wire AC system. That means we are introducing one neutral wire here. That is your neutral wire. Okay. The current is, and this is the sixth number, I6. Here again RMS voltage equals to root 2 Vm as previous one. For simplicity, I should mention 2 Vm upon root 2, that is equals to, okay. Now, I6 equals to W6 equals to 1 and 2, and it is a neutral wire. As I mentioned earlier, neutral wire is having half of the cross-sectional area as compared to the phase wire. So volume equals to again 2.5 A6 into L. Now 2.5 into P square, rho L square, Vm square, cos square phi into W6. That is equals to 5 upon 5k upon 8 cos square pi. That is the volume. Okay. I am not going for the mathematical calculation. Just put these value, compare with this one, and you will obtain this data definitely. Okay. This is the representation of two phase and having four wires. Means this is representing one phase, this is a set another phase. These are the two phases and this we are having four wires here. But as we know that we have to transfer only P watts power to the transmission line, that means each phase will contain the power P by 2. Thank you. this to P by 2. Okay. So here now line current I7 equals to P by 2. Okay. Then W7 equals to since there are four wires, so line losses will be happening in all four wires, so we are multiplying it with four times. Okay, so it can be written as 4 upon P square rho L upon 8 times Vm square cos square 5, that is given by 2, and that is rho A upon S. Okay, from here what we are determining A7. Now A7 is equals to P square rho L upon 2 Vm square cos square 5 into W7, and volume equals to 4 times A7 into L, that is equals to 4 P square rho L square 2 Vm square cos square 5 W7. After comparing it with this one, then what we are obtaining? Now that is equals to K by 2 cos square 5. This is the volume of conductor metal required in 2-phase 4-wire system. In this case, what is the specialty? In this case, both phases are carrying the current. This phase is carrying the current IF, and similarly this phase is carrying the current IF. And combining, that current is flowing through the neutral wire, that is equals to root 2 IF. Okay? Since the area of cross section of neutral wire in this case is 1 by root 2 times of the area of cross section of the phase conductor, so here the resistance of ground wire is given by Here we have, when we are talking about the line losses, now all three conductors are carrying the current, so definitely line losses will happen in all three conductors. So for these two phases, the line losses are given 2 IIT square into RA, and for the neutral wire or ground wire, it is taken as root 2 IT square RJ. Why root 2? Because when we are going for mathematical expression, it is equivalent to root 2 times what the current flowing through the phase current. Okay? So current is root 2 IT square and RJ upon root 2. Okay? That is equivalent to RG, this is represented by RG, that equals to R8 upon root 2. So I am writing here R8 upon root 2, that is equivalent to 2 plus okay, because this root 2 will cut it one part, so it will become, it will become equals to root 2 times. So for the volume point of view, we have to take the volume of these two conductors together and the volume of this neutral wire individually, because its cross section area is root 2 times the cross section area of the phase conductor. That's why we are taking it as separate. After taking common A8 into L, we are getting this one. By putting this value here, what we are getting? 2 plus root 2 is the whole square. After solving this one, we are obtaining the value of volume of conductor is equals to 1.457 divided by cos square pi into k. here, since we are taking three phases and we want to transmit only P power, that means each phase will take the 1/3 of the total power. So this will take P by 3 power, this will take P by 3 and this will take P by 3 power. So power transmitted per phase equals to P by 3 and armature voltage equals to U1 U2. Okay, therefore the line current, this is the line current I9 equals to Pm upon root 3 root 2 Vm upon cos phi. Okay, now line losses W9 equals to 3 conductors are there, so 3 In square into R9. Again putting these values, 3 into P by 3 all square P upon 3 root 2 Vm cos phi all square into rho L upon A9. Okay, equals to P square rho L upon 6 Vm square cos square phi into A9, or A9 equals to P square rho L upon 6 Vm square cos square phi W9, and volume equals to P A9 into L. Okay, and that would be equals to P square rho L square upon 2 Vm square cos square phi W9, and that is equals to K cos square phi. Okay, so this is the volume required for 3-phase 3-wire system. In the 3-phase 4-wire system, we are introducing one neutral wire here, that is represented here. Okay, so here I can put the same P by 3 root 2 Vm cos phi, and similarly, since no current is flowing through the neutral wire, since we are considering the balanced load, so all the phases are taking same value of load current, that's why there is no current flowing through the neutral wire, so there would be no line losses in the neutral wire. That's why W10 equals to 3 I10 square R10, and that is equals to area of cross section is half of the phase conductor, so here we are taking 3.5 A10 into L, and after solving this we will obtain 7K upon 12 cos square phi as volume. Okay, and this is all about the comparison of conductor material required in the overhead system for different kind of power transmission system. That's all.